I'm back with you. Hello again. The signal's back, so I thought I'd switch back on again. Hello, David. Hello, Adrian. Hello, Sinan Kilic. Hello, Liz. The signal's back. I think because I'm probably on top of the ridge now, it's kind of coming in from both sides of the valley. Hello, Annie. Welcome along to 2,000 meter height mountains here in the valley, Salzach Valley, named after the river Salzach. And we're above the village of, or the town of Neukirchen. This is a great skiing area actually. In the winter it's super. So I'm just doing the ridge walk, having come up by cable car to get to the dumpling festival. I had some dumplings, did a couple of short scopes, but there's very few people viewing, so I cut the scopes short, and I'll probably do one more when I go back from this sweet dumpling. Austria does some great dumplings, you know, some lovely sweet ones as well. Yeah, they look good, didn't they? one was a spinach one, and the other was a cheese and mushroom dumpling. So I had two, and it was swimming in a bit of a buttery sauce. Yeah, it's good. It's very wholesome. It's ideal if you're in the mountains, you know. And yeah, that was the second one. It was next to the spinach one. I enjoy the spinach one. I normally have spinach dumplings if they're on the menu, just on their own. And anyway, the one I'm looking forward to, and I'm going to scope it for you or photograph it for you, is the apricot dumpling. It's a lovely dessert, you know. It's a super dessert. There's an apricot. It's all hot, and it's got a nice dough surrounding it. You know, it's been done in the oven, and there's sugar breadcrumbs, and usually some sort of drizzle of sauce to go with it. You know, raspberry sauce or whatever it might be. I'm looking forward to that, maybe a cup of coffee. I've had a beer and two dumplings today, and that's probably done me. Although you never know who you're going to meet at these places, you know, and as soon as you meet somebody that you know, you quite often end up sitting down to a little beer, a small beer or whatever. Anyway, it's Sunday, who cares? So thank you for being on my ridge walk. Trying to make some room in my tummy for the nice dessert. Yeah, it's very cloudy today. When I left home, which is 15 minutes drive from here, it was actually sunny. You know, there was sun coming through the clouds. There wasn't any low cloud. And when I drove down out of Mittersill, where I live, I noticed that there was very low cloud over Neukirchen, and it looked a bit thundery as well. So it wouldn't surprise me if we got some rain later. But it's strange, the weather can change. You know, you can get a thunderstorm happening in a village, and 15 minutes up the road, it's still quite nice. But we've had a gorgeous summer, people. We really have. It's been the best summer we've ever had here on record. Temperatures exceeding the 30s at times. 37, 38 was as hot as I've ever had it in Austria. Yes. Drop of a dime, yeah, the weather does change as quickly as that. But anyway, I quite like it, you know. I took the precaution of wearing or taking a sweater with me, otherwise I would have just been in t-shirt and lederhosen I'm in Lederhosen today, folks. I know you don't believe me, but I thought I would wear my Lederhosen for the dumpling festival. Besides that, they're very comfortable. It's a great trouser to wear in the summer months or any time of year, really. Now, I wonder where this path is going to lead us. Is it going to lead us up the garden path, I wonder? There's the trusty red, white, red on the gatepost. It's quite a cool breeze up here today, you know? It's almost long trouser weather, really. Let me see, and I wonder what you look like in your Lederhosen. Now I'm going to show you, if I can. Hi, Cheryl! Cheryl, thanks for all your stuff on Twitter, that's great. I'm going to show everybody my Lederhosen. I know you can't wait. If I can find a way of propping it up here. There we go. Oh, I'm too low down. Oh, I've got to have to jump up now. Let's tilt it for you and show you the bottom half of my Lederhosen. There they are, folks. Don't they look good? I'm holding my tummy in. Genuine Hirschleder. I got them 2 years ago. You know, my mum used to dress me up in these trousers when I was young. Not these, smaller pair. When we were growing up in England, our parents, who were from Austria, they dressed us up in national costume, you know, to go to church on Sunday and all that kind of stuff. So I haven't had a pair of leather hosen ever since then. And then 2 years ago, I decided for my birthday I would get them. Anyway, that's enough of me. Hope you enjoyed that. I should have said screenshots, people. Tweet it at me. Look at those colours. Haven't said that for a while. You're craving with appetite. Okay, well, it won't be too long. I reckon, well, maybe another 40 minutes before I get back to the Wildkogelalm. And then I look forward to taking a photo of my apricot dumpling. There better be some left. And if they run out of apricot dumplings, then there's one of my favorite desserts called the Germknödel. Germ is the German word for yeast. It's a yeast dumpling and it's really, really great. If you need energy, it's a delicious dessert which you have with poppy seeds sprinkled over it. You can have it with hot butter, hot melted butter, or you can have it with vanilla sauce. So there's always the Germknödel to fall back to. And both of them make a great picture. You may have seen a scope of mine several weeks ago on the mountain top, where I actually scoped the Germknödel. Oh, the battery's getting low as well. Battery's getting low, folks. I'm still up in the heights, 2,000 meters high roughly, and it's foggy, all right. Thank you for being with me, because I mean, you're not getting much other than me talking about things. You're not seeing much, but it gives you a first-hand idea what it's like, or what it can be like this time of year. We've been sweltering in 30 degrees of heat this summer, quite often. A little bit cooler up here in the mountains, usually about 10 degrees cooler, and that's looking down towards a mountain farm over there. In fact, that's the back of one of the ski areas. People pop in there in the winter for a Glühwein, I'm sure, on the way down with their skis. You see the fog? Yes, I see the fog. You see the fog, I see the fog. Periscope sees the fog. But before long, it will all be forgotten about. Do you get it? Forgotten. trying to keep my hand still as possible. And we may have lost the signal here. I'm hoping not, because I want to show you the view from over the side of this little ridge here.